How to raise dogs, feed them, use them, and their types of food. Dogs training. Many people want to breed dogs for many different reasons, but dog breeding is not an easy subject. It needs experience in applying some specific measures to maintain the health and safety of the dog, the most important of which is the dog's diet, as a balanced diet for dogs is very important to maintain their growth and health, as dogs must obtain all the nutrients and vitamins important for growth, and they must obtain special vaccines to protect them from various parasitic diseases, and carefully follow the advice of the veterinarian. Dogs have different needs for the elements according to their age, and the breeder must be aware of these subtle details to protect his dogs. Uses of dogs. Dogs are considered one of the most common types of pets among those that humans raise and take care of, and the origins of dogs are due to the wolf family, but after a person performed the operations of taming and breeding them, they became pets and coexisted with humans since ancient times, and many people raise dogs in mostly for the purpose of providing protection, as well as amusement. The proverb is set with loyalty of dogs and their love for their owner, and some use them for hunting and guarding purposes, in addition to their use in military operations, past and present. Dog nutrition. The type of food provided to dogs differs according to the size and age of the dog. The amount of food that must be provided to a small dog differs from a large one. Age also plays a major role in determining the type of dog food. Feeding young puppies. Feeding newborn puppies in the first 3 months needs careful care. The breeder should start to convert the puppy from the mother's milk diet to the puppy's diet gradually and regularly by keeping him away for short and long periods of time from his mother. The importance of this step is to make the puppy gradually move away from the mother's care. This process is called weaning, and it is best to start in the third or fourth week. There is no need to feed the puppy any additional food before weaning, but in the event that the mother is sick and does not produce enough milk, formula milk or a veterinarian is used for guidance. During weaning, the dog is fed processed food intended for dogs and is moistened with warm water, and food is presented repeatedly after weaning to maintain the level of blood sugar, and if any side effects occur, such as diarrhea and vomiting, the veterinarian must be consulted as soon as possible. Feeding adult dogs. The food provided to adult dogs should be sufficient to meet their energy needs and replace the body's cells and tissues. And the amount of food provided to the dog must be proportional to its size and energy, so that it does not exceed its need, causing diseases resulting from the accumulation of fat, and not less than its needs, and it becomes wasted and weak. The activity of the dog varies according to its type and movement, so the educator has to determine the amount of food sufficient for the body of his dog. The amount of food required for the dog can be determined by the veterinarian, and this amount may increase in the winter, or when the dog performs additional activity, or if he has a disease. It is usually recommended to provide 2 meals a day for an adult dog, with a time interval of 8 to 10 hours. This method helps in controlling animal behavior. Some people divide meals into 3 meals, breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and each meal has a set time, and it differs according to the type and age of the dog. During which meals containing raw eggs are served to be a special meal for dogs that practice violent exercises, and are served after the 6th month of the dog's life, and for the meal that contains meat and bones, it is given to the dog daily in order to strengthen his jaws and fill his need for protein and is given, and can be replaced dinner as with the remainder of lunch, but not every day, until the age of 6 months. Types of dog food. With different types and sizes of dogs, there are special foods for them that have become widespread in the markets and in different types, and all that the breeder has to do is put the ready food for the dog on specific dates. There are 3 different types of dog food, and they are dry eating. It consists of fats, vitamins, bone powder, and some dry meats, in addition to minerals, carbohydrates, and some salts in appropriate quantities, where they are mixed together in the form of balls in small sizes. This type is distinguished by the fact that it prevents weight gain, in addition to containing all the necessary nutrients. Canned food. It is a food that consists of a mixture of rice, meat, ground bones, vitamins, and salt, but this food is very expensive. Home eating for dogs. This food is distinguished by the fact that it is made by the breeder, and it increases the dog's bond with humans, and it is not expensive. Because it is most likely a byproduct of human eating. General notes on dog nutrition. The home dog breeder must adhere to some important notes in maintaining the dog's good health, including these notes. The meal should be medium to warm. Liver food is twice a week, in order not to increase the level of uric acid in the body. Avoid eating leftovers that contain large amounts of salts or fats, especially before the age of 6 months. Teaching the dog to wait until the food is placed in front of him, then instruct him to eat, so as not to expose the breeder to danger. Providing good, clean water to the dog, and constantly replenishing it. Not giving the dog any additional meals that may cause excess fat in his body, and thus increase his weight beyond the normal limit. If you like video, give it like and share with your friends. For more tips and tricks, subscribe the channel.